I told the witch doctor I was in love with you. I told the witch doctor I was in love with you. And then the witch doctor, he told me what to do. He said that ooh-ee, ooh-ah-ah, ting-tang, walla-walla-bing-bang. Ooh-ee, ooh-ah-ah, ting-tang, walla-walla-bang-bang. Come on and ooh-ee, ooh-ah-ah, ting-tang, walla-walla-bing-bang. Ooh-ee, ooh-ah-ah, ting-tang, walla-walla-bang-bang. Ooh-ee, ooh-ah-ah, ting-tang, walla-walla-bing-bang. Ooh-ee, ooh-ah-ah, ting-tang, walla-walla-bang-bang.
Happy Halloween from all of us here at KRAC 88.1, Chuck and Don in the Morning. And it's our Halloween special and our company Halloween party as well. Happy Halloween, everybody out there. So that's
enjoy
good.
Yourself.
Be safe. And stuff. And stuff.
Chuck
and Don here with you with Radar. And
hi.
David Stress.
Good morning.
And basically, half of the entire staff of the radio station. A bunch of people here this morning that wouldn't usually be here this early.
I know.
Eating and drinking and talking about Halloween stuff and having fun. One person who would be here, though, even though there's a lot of people here that usually wouldn't be here because they're here for the Halloween party, Sherry Winters, our roving reporter and weather girl, would always be here bright and early and bushy-tailed to give us the weather.
She's always here.
Let's do some weather. She's out in the lobby right now partying with everybody. And Sherry, you
here?
Yeah,
we're having the weather. A good time.
All right, that sounds good.
I see you guys. I don't know what Radar's doing, but whatever it is, it's cool.
Radar's doing.
Okay, so I'm going to get you the weather for today.
All right.
I'm just here out in the lobby, but I don't have the weather for today. So right now, it is 66 degrees. Not really going to get too much warmer than that today. But later tonight, around trick-or-treating time, it's going to get to the 40s, and then way later, we're going to hit a low of 33 in the middle of the night.
Ooh,
there's no precipitation expected, and just a cool breeze, partly cloudy.
All right, that sounds good. So you enjoying the festivities here?
Yeah, I really dig these pumpkin pancakes. I don't know who made them, but they're good.
I knew you'd like those. We got some good
Kit Kats. We got all the goodies. I did bring Reese's Frankensteins.
Oh,
yay. Cups.
Yeah, I know. Love those.
I talk about those a lot, but they're really passionate. Like, I'm passionate about them. So.
Okay.
Bring them on.
Booth.
The studio. Candy,
and
candy.
I'm going as Dorothy. I know my friend Elaine is going as Glinda the Good Witch. So I'm chilling as Dorothy.
We see sort of a theme there. You guys are best friends. We know that. So you're going doing a little Wizard of Oz theme thing, huh?
You sort of got a theme there. Don.
Yeah, I hear you and Max have the same costume.
Oh, boy.
What a coincidence.
Yeah,
twins.
I mean, that's hilarious. I mean, you guys got yourself in a pickle.
You guys
Speaking of pickles, can we get some pickles out here? Like, I know it's kind of early in the morning, but, like, I think we should have, like, pickles, like, as an hors d'oeuvre.
I'm sure we can find some pickles or something.
Can we get some pickles?
I don't like Bill's costume.
Oh, Bill's?
Yeah, I don't like his costume either. It's pretty crappy.
Hey, Bill, your costume looks ridiculous.
There's nothing wrong with my costume.
He doesn't know the Hulk.
Yeah, okay.
I know the Hulk.
Okay. All right, happy...
And I do have my pitchfork in my little the Hulk always has, so I do know the Hulk.
That's a real Hulk thing.
All right, you enjoy yourself, Bill.
Okay,
happy Halloween, everybody.
All right, thank you, Sherry. Happy Halloween, Sherry.
The Hulk on his boat.
Thank you. We'll see you a little bit later, Sherry. Microphone out there in the lobby and tell us an update on what's going on with the Halloween party here, company Halloween party at KRAC 88.1. We're recording this on Friday, October the 30th, for rebroadcast on Freezenaudible Pop Culture TV and a couple other places that have decided to air the show. I don't know right offhand what they are, but this will all be rebroadcast the following day when we're not actually here doing this, because tomorrow is Halloween. So you're listening to tomorrow, which is today, on Saturday night, which is Halloween. So
we got it, Dan.
Yesterday, and okay. Oh, so you understand that?
Okay, we got it.
Thanks, Dan. I think I was probably lose my mind trying to explain it. Yeah, okay, so let's get into some stuff now. Are we mingling? Oh, we're going to mingle first.
It's mingle in the morning time.
Chuck.
Time for
mingling. Okay, let's mingle there. Turn the mic back on out there. And anyone who wants to say howdy or get on the mic
in the hallway
and talk to us a little bit here this morning during our Halloween party, go ahead and line up and do so.
Hi there. We got somebody here. Who's this?
Oh,
hi there.
Oh, okay.
I don't recognize this person.
I'd like to say hello.
Hi.
Hi, Chuck and Don.
Happy Halloween.
Hi.
I'm new here, so you may not even know who I am, but my name is Anna, and I work in sales, and I just wanted to say happy Halloween, and this is quite a party.
Well, we hope you have a lot of fun, and welcome to the KRAC family here in Mellonville. I'm sure you'll completely and totally love it. I don't know what that meant, really. What the hell is that? Who else we got out there?
Hey, how you doing? I'm Todd. Todd Houston from HR.
Okay. What are you supposed to be, Todd?
I'm dressed as a face mask.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I would have never actually thought of that as a costume, but it's a pretty good idea.
Neither would I. Yeah,
okay.
It's pretty good.
And
everybody thinks
I'm
really topical and cool for doing it.
Hi, yeah. Hi.
Oh, hey, Elaine. Yeah, we saw you a little earlier, but we didn't get a chance to talk to you.
Hi. Yeah, I'm Elaine.
Hi, Elaine.
Hendricks.
Yes, it's a great costume. Glinda the
I'm Glinda the Good Witch.
No, it's not.
Don't listen
glitter.
To him. He's trying
this
to make a joke.
Glitter.
But it's not even a real character.
Glinda
real
the Glitter.
He doesn't really think you're that.
Fairy.
And I'm going as Dorothy.
Oh, yeah. I hear Sherry in the background there, too. So are a lot of people coming by as far as, like, listeners to trick-or-treat or to say hi?
We had a couple people walk by the glass. We've got a couple trick-or-treaters. A couple people came in.
All right. Sounds good. Sounds like you guys are having a lot of fun out there, and there's a lot of good
Dorothy
food out
in
there
the back.
Too, huh?
I have, like, a couple goodie bags. I've got pens, business cards.
Okay. We got anybody else out there who wants to talk?
It's a thing that shoots out some smoke.
How about a fan? Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, let's have a listener.
This is a listener that, I guess, came down to this station to talk to us.
Hi, ma'am. What's your
name? This is Susie Q, and I've been a fan of your show for a long time. So
Susie
I thought
Q.
I'd come down and see what's going on. You're talking about a Halloween party here, so I thought I'd come down and get some snacks and say hello. Okay, happy Halloween from Susie.
Happy Halloween, that's great.
Happy Halloween.
Happy that you came by to say hi.
Come on down and get some snacks and have a good time.
All right.
More than welcome.
Happy Halloween, everybody. Looks like everybody's having a real good time and enjoying themselves at the Halloween party here at KRAC. To be rebroadcast for your enjoyment tomorrow, which is today, which is tonight.
Yeah.
All right. I think I got that straight. All of a sudden,
what are we doing now?
We're going to get into your top 10, aren't we?
All of a sudden, we need a bigger boat.
We got the because I think I know what you're talking about, but you know what I mean, like.
Yeah, we're going to do the.
Okay, cool.
So we're going to do top 10 things.
Take it away, Chuck.
Okay. All right.
What is this?
Can we turn down the fish music from the Jaws movie or whatever the hell?
Yep. I cut it out.
So for the last couple of days, you know that all the television stations have been, you know, just bombarding you with slasher flicks and, you know, what they consider to be horror Halloween classics.
Yeah.
And I personally, because I'm a kind of a connoisseur, you know, of like, I'm sort of a connoisseur of horror films. So I don't consider every slasher flick that comes down the pike, you know, especially in the late 80s there and in the 90s, and then in like the sort of resurge of horror that we had in the early 2000s with like The Ring and Saw and shit like that.
And,
I mean, I like The Ring, but I don't like Saw and stuff. But anyways, the point I'm trying to make is that they've been showing you all kinds of, you know, marathons of horror movies on TV for the last couple of days. And Channel 35 here locally in Mellonville.
35 Alive.
A good channel. You give them a shout out anyway.
35 Alive.
35 Alive. You know those guys.
Oh, yeah. I'm down with those guys.
I watch that channel a lot when I'm chilling at home. And lately what they've been doing is taking an entire franchise, like an entire genre, and running it for you for the Halloweens. Building up to Halloween.
Yeah.
So, like, day before yesterday, it was like every Nightmare on Elm Street, you know?
Cool.
And then when they were done running all those, they ran every Friday the 13th. And then when they were done running all those, they ran every Halloween. And that's what they're doing today, is they're finishing up running all the Halloweens to build up for Halloween. So what I noticed while watching that is that there are certain things that are in every, I mean, I literally mean every single horror movie. Like, I know that the Scream movies talked about the rules, you know, but these aren't necessarily rules. Some of them do cross over into that kind of, you know, thing, you know, because they're the same as some of the rules, like, you know, like we all know the, you know, having sex one, or
right,
you know, smoking dope one, because there's weed in every single one of those movies, but it's always just before someone gets killed.
Yeah,
they
true.
Smoke it, or you know, yeah, get naked and jump in the water. But
yeah,
I'm going to talk about that too. Anyway, okay.
So these are the top 10.
Yeah, right. Exactly. It's the top 10 things that always happen in horror movies. I mean, always. You can absolutely count on them. Doesn't matter who the director is or what the year is.
Okay.
Or the genre or anything.
Right.
But they almost never happen in real life. Now, I put the almost in there to clarify, because I'm sure some of them could happen, but they just don't, you know. It's like, right. Here, number 10, okay? The cat fall scare. That's in every single horror movie. It's when you think there's going to be a jump scare, you know, and you're ready for it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And it happens. Or but maybe you're not ready for it, but
it's
when
a
it
false
happens,
scare.
You think, oh, here we go, and then it's just a cat.
Yeah. Yeah, I know about that.
It's yeah, I mean, like every time, not only every time is it that, as far as it being a not the bad guy or the killer or the villain,
not
but
who
it's
you thought
always
it was.
A cat. It's never like a dog, or it's never like a possum. Or,
yeah, good point.
Yeah, right. You know, it's just like
it's always a cat.
Always a cat. I mean, what if there's no cats in the area? You know, I mean, it's ridiculous. So number 10 is the cat false scare, every single
cat
one of them.
Cat false scare. Okay, I got you.
Skinny dipping. And I know that's like being in the shower. That's like vulnerable. Like, you know, you're vulnerable when your clothes are on the shore and you're swimming. And so, like, you know, that's a good time for you'd be picked off by the villain of the movie. So I understand that.
Yeah.
That dates back all the way to Psycho, you know. And see.
Ah, you are
well,
a connoisseur.
Well, I told you I was a connoisseur.
You do go way back.
But the skinny dipping thing, it gets kind of ridiculous, because not every girl wants to go skinny dipping, and not every person, you know, one of the times out of the four times that you decide to go down there, you know, to the lake in the middle of the night, you're going to have your trunks, you know, you don't always have to get in naked, you know, so there's constant skinny dipping. Okay. And the number 8, splashing your face with water in the sink when you're like stressed out.
Yeah.
And I'm sure people do that, you know, but it's not always in the sink.
Mm-hmm.
Where you get your water to splash your face, and you don't always splash your face, you know, but that's like what everybody needs to do.
Yeah.
In order to clear their head, look
up in their mirror.
In the sink. I mean, I could have done just the top 10 times, or the top 25 or 125 times that happens in a movie, because it's
people wash,
not even just horror.
Wash their face in the sink. I've seen that in almost every movie ever.
Okay. Everyone smokes weed before sex. Doesn't matter who you are. There'd be a lot of people that would say, no, thank you. You know, I don't do drugs or whatever.
Yeah.
But no, everybody, because, you know,
I've seen that a million times.
You can't pass it up, or you wouldn't be considered a bad person worthy of being killed extremely.
Exactly. That's your prelude to death. So you've got to do something that's considered bad. I mean, if you said, hey, no, thank you to the weed,
then they could
you know,
just
maybe
go
off the kid would
get around and
there wouldn't be other than millions of deaths.
Yeah. It could save a lot of lives.
Okay.
Yeah,
number 6, everything on television is an old black and white movie. I don't understand that. There's no current shows. There's no, you know, I mean, a lot of these take place in the 80s. There's no like rock videos on, or like Pee Wee Herman or any kind of 80s stuff. It's always like some black and white old movie, you know, pertaining to whatever they're dealing with. Like if they're dealing with a werewolf, it's a werewolf movie. If they're dealing with a witch, it's a cartoon of like a witch, you know.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
It's
totally
so predictable after a while when you see a lot of these movies back to back that you wonder
it's
how
like,
do
why
we
are
even
they all watching
as like a genre
the same thing.
Okay, number 5. Here we are, the top 5. If you're gonna have sex, you're gonna die. I think we all know that one. That was talked about.
That's
in many movies. Number 4, women go on walks in the woods at night alone to think all the time.
Mm.
See, that just doesn't happen.
No,
the girl knows that she's better off not walking through the dark woods by herself. And then slowly stripping down to nothing and jumping in the water. That's not usually a good way to clear your head.
No.
Number 3, all old people are drunks and crazy. You know, they're always like doom prophets telling you that you're going to die. Or like they're always like drunk when they see the villain do some heinous shit. And nobody else does. Nobody believes them.
Right, because they're not credible.
Now, number 2 and number 1 are kind of linked, because it's because of number 2 that number 1 happens. And it's
this is
the one. This is why I had to give it number 2 and number 1, because it's like, what? How is this the deal? Okay.
All right.
You think that these killers and these people would be smarter. So, and some stuff just doesn't happen.
I don't
know where it comes from. So, number 2,
killers
never clean up.
in horror films.
In these movies, where you got in real life people like trying to clean up and, you know, wash things off so there's no blood, fingerprints or anything like that. These killers don't give a shit, you know, because they're not worried about going to jail. So they never clean up. And then there's another reason they don't clean up, and that's number one. And that's the body count parade at the end of every movie.
Yeah.
Whoever the last person is usually your, like, you know, your final girl or whatever. She witnesses every killing, the results of every killing that's happened for the last hour and 45 minutes. People tucked away in drawers and, you know, fallen, you know, out of closets and wherever. And then this is the big one that I had to give like a two-part answer to. Number one, the body count parade. And then the one body in that body count parade that's always hanging upside down.
They always come flopping down.
Corpse that just comes and flops down. Like, what is it? Like, that wasn't necessarily how it was. The person was killed.
Yeah, but they're always like raped
there to be discovered that way.
Yeah, it's like a
movie. And then the other thing that just came to my head now, I just thought of now that I forgot to add to that, is that especially in the Jason movies, the Friday the 13th, he's always throwing someone through a window that he just killed. What I've been doing, and just talking.
Your best friend or your mother, your girlfriend or whatever.
So, yeah, that's very a lot true. Of stuff.
That was good.
I had a lot to think about.
Great.
As far as top 10. Find, you know, I mean, I probably could have gone top 20, but then we'd be here, you know, all day and all night. But those are the top 10 things that always, always happen in a horror movie, but almost never, ever, ever happen in real life. So there you go.
That was good.
All right. That was really fantastic. Good. That's almost a little bit, you know, just like too much to think about.
Right.
I might want to get that printed out, you know, a list so I can... get home and study it. So anyway, okay, what do we got? What do we got next? I know we got a lot of fun stuff going on here.
What's going on, Radar?
What's that, Radar?
We're waiting for the Dark Valley Sunshine Morning Blues Roadshow Network band. They haven't shown up yet.
Oh,
and
damn.
We're also waiting for our phone call from Jack Torres from jail. Mm. And we're about to get ready to tally up the votes for the best costume, competition.
What the hell's wrong with Radar? You all right, man?
It's for the winner.
Okay. Good. What are you doing?
No word from the band or anything else.
Okay. So you just
no Jack Torres yet. But I have a ghost story. I could tell a ghost story if I got it. I got a ghost story. Yeah,
that's good. Do a ghost story.
Okay, you have to turn the lights down, and I take the flashlight on my face. Yeah. Okay. Ready?
All right. Yeah. Lights
here
are out.
Here's
the flashlight.
The horror story.
All right.
That you have to be very careful.
Huh?
Don't get scared, but listen and to what I say, because you can't be caught at night around here.
What?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It's an original story. You never heard it before, I'm sure.
Oh, so this is one of your stories.
It's about the hunchback of the Bridge of the Nose.
What the fuck?
He's a hunchback, and he lives under the bridge.
He's a hunchback.
The name of the bridge is the Nose.
The story you're about to tell is about a hunchback under a bridge called the Nose.
Yes, he is a very scary guy with the hunch on his back.
With the hunch,
the hunchback is a complete nervous breakdown.
Oh, he's telling the story.
He's been decapitation. He's been cutting off the cattle's heads with the cattle decapitation, and he got it because of that. Doing those things, he got a beef. Tapeworm, and he got the rigor mortis set in, so he started to fight the lumberjacks and the big rickets and the crickets.
This
that
actually
came out of the woods.
Wow, he this is a scary story.
Case of the furious rabies.
It's terrifying.
And he couldn't eat any strawberries. Had the abscess tooth for about a week. It's very scary.
It's not funny at all.
Like
it's very scary.
Under the bridge, and he come out and say, "You watch out and don't do that anymore, and deliver the Oriental food for me and the zucchini. My friend zucchini. He had a friend who had cauliflower ear, but they did not call him cauliflower. They called him the what I just said.
Zucchini?
What did I just say?
Zucchini.
He would know. I remember now. He's zucchini.
Holy shit.
And that's how they killed everybody in the small town that they lived in, is with the zucchini. And guess what town that was?
I have no friggin' idea.
Very end, the scary part.
Oh, okay. What town?
It was Northern Millenville. Yay! Oh, it's spooky because it's where you are.
We're in Southern Millenville.
But that's close, though, huh? It's too close for my comfort to have a guy like that. you know, he... A very irritable guy. He's got irritability all the time.
I am scared.
And, you know...
I'm terrified right now.
African sleeping sickness.
Okay.
In a swimming pool with grandma. We used to tell that in the old country, and it scared everybody all the time.
Okay.
Because nobody wants to be in Northern Millenville, that's for sure. Jesus.
Wow. Okay. Well, that was great. That deserves that. I don't know what that deserves. It probably deserves some sort of serious attention to your mental state, Radar, and your ability to speak to people and convey a message of some sort of information that is understandable by other people. Oh boy, I don't even know where to start to ask you what you just said, or what we're supposed to think of what you just said, or even if any of this is real. I'm starting to think that maybe this is all just some sort of big nightmare. Okay, so thanks for the ghost story, Radar. And I am getting word that we have our phone call finally now. Is this true? Jock yep. Torres is on the line?
Yep, Jock's
all
on
right,
the line.
All right, let's waste no more time
exactly.
whatsoever. Let's get into this right now.
Yeah, good morning. This is Jock Torres.
Good morning, Mr. Torres.
I'm Jock Torres.
Yes, you are. Do you know who we are?
Chuck and Don.
Yeah.
On 88.1, I listen to you guys all the time.
Oh, great.
Or I used to before I got thrown in here.
So what happened?
I was just doing what I normally do, and just in this climate of corona disease.
Yeah.
China people disease or whatever.
Okay.
Things are a little different, you know.
That's very true. It is kind of different.
A lot of the shit that I used to do.
That it is kind of different, Mr. Torres.
Yeah.
So what is the deal?
Well, I run for all the offices, and I've never won any of them. But I know that I can do what I set out to do, and I'm gonna someday I'm gonna do it. So I'm just gonna keep running. As soon as I get out of here, I'll just start up my campaign again.
Well, what is it you're trying to do?
Yeah, well, a lot of what I was doing wasn't even illegal. I mean, it's not illegal to kick people out of your party or your house because they're not wearing masks, and it's not illegal to, you know, blast Def Leppard and Whitesnake music really loud.
Right.
It's not even illegal to have senior citizen wet T-shirt contests or,
No, but you were kicking people out of your party for wearing masks, and you were also serving minors alcohol.
Well, yeah, right. that is illegal. Yeah, that was kind of what got me in trouble. And then the big one, of course, was the cooking and dealing of meth. That there's really no getting around that.
No, there isn't.
But you got to pay the bills. You got to keep the lights on. Because I'm Jock Torres.
Well, I'm sure there are other things you could do.
Right.
Keep the lights on.
Of course, it was the cooking and dealing of meth. There's really no getting around that.
No.
But, you know, you got to pay the bills. You got to keep the lights on. Because I'm Jock Torres.
Deja, are we?
I keep the lights on.
Are we having
Deja? Because I'm Jock Torres.
Whoa. What is happening? Are you there? Okay, yeah, you're Jock Torres.
You guys are having, like, a crazy Halloween party, you know, down there. You're doing crazy stuff.
Well, yeah, but it's not illegal.
Yeah, well, that guy who called me, who can barely speak English or sounds like he's from some third world country, he's...
illegal.
He should be arrested.
You might have a point.
They should deport him or something. Yeah. I mean, he's not from Mellonville. I can tell just by, you know, the first three noises out of his mouth.
Right.
You know, that he's some sort of, you know, towel head or something.
Okay, that's enough of that kind of talk.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'm glad you guys are having a good time. Keep on keeping on. Happy Halloween to everybody out there. And I'll be out probably in about, 3 months or less.
Only 3 months?
And,
why do you think it would be such a short time?
Because I'm Jock Torres. It was my first offense on that. Okay. I mean, I've been doing it for 16 years, but first time I ever got caught, so, you know. Oh, okay. I'm getting the signal from my people that I got to go back to my cell, but I'm going to ask them if I can maybe get a copy of this and listen to it, you know, and play it on my boombox or something.
All right. Of the interview, you're saying?
You still there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Because I'm Jock Torres.
You're...
Because I'm Jock Torres.
Yes, you are.
Because I'm Jock Torres.
Yes, you are. It sounds like maybe we've hit the end of our conversation here. Hello? And he's gone. That's as strange as he is, that it makes total sense that's how he would end a phone conversation. Okay, so folks, that was Jock Torres, a local politician, although I don't think he's ever held an office of any kind. He's just always, since I remember, I mean, as far back as I can remember, because, you know, the guy started running for ridiculous offices and several offices at a young age. So he's always been running for something or running away from something, usually the police. Okay, so it's Chuck and Don in the morning, and we're looking at about 5 minutes to 8 o'clock, or time flies when you're listening to Ghost Stories from Radar and having a very, very surface conversation of shallow. It's after 8 o'clock now with Jock Torres. So what time is
it's 5 minutes after 8.
It's 5 after 8. Okay, 5 after 8 in the a.m. Thank you very much, because my brain is fried. And I guess, so what's next for Mix? I mean, that's it.
Yeah.
We've done a lot of things here this morning. Oh, no, we're still waiting on this group, right?
Yeah, I can't wait to hear some music.
Our musical guest that's going to show up. The Dark Valley Sun.
No, it's not. No.
Okay.
That, Chuck. Don, the Dark Valley Sunshine Morning Blues Roadshow Network Band, they did not make it here. I just heard on the phone that all 15 members of the band perished in the bus crash 25 minutes ago outside of Liberty City.
Oh,
so,
okay.
No music from those guys. They are dead.
Wow. That's unfortunate.
Okay. You're welcome.
I don't know what to say to that. That's kind of.
Yeah, I don't know what to say either, man.
I mean, you know,
this whole situation is strange now. I feel like I'm in Outer Limits or something.
Radar for that information.
Ever since that, I think we were all hypnotized by whatever the hell Radar story.
I really don't know how to follow that. So I guess it's safe to say that the Dark Valley Sunshine Morning Blues Roadshow Network Band will not be performing on the program here, so we'll come up with some other thing. I got some Reese's peanut butter cups here. Maybe we could hand those out to people.
Oh, but here I got the results just now, hot off the presses, time for of that the best already. Costume.
Okay, because I really give a shit.
The winner of the costume contest.
Yeah, I don't really.
This
I don't
year.
Care. But I mean, now that we got some free time, because we're not going to have a musical guest because they're all dead.
the 88.1 KRAC Halloween.
I think this party's getting out of
control. Winner.
Yes. What do we have? All right. Okay. Well, I just can't wait to hear who out of all these incredibly creative people who has the best costume. So let's.
Okay,
let's
the runner-up is Leonard Wabash.
Is the runner-up? Okay, yeah, that makes sense. All right, great. That's
alien
great.
Face.
Yeah, he looked great.
Looks great. Looks just like the show.
Characters
That he's trying to look like.
That he's got.
Okay, so good for him. That's Leonard. He's
from
the
Twilight Zone. You know,
the runner-up.
Messed up faces.
Or second place.
That's
you know,
really good stuff.
Thing.
I mean, I thought he.
First place.
I don't know who could even be better than that.
For the costume contest for this year.
Okay, so who is the best costume of 2020 Halloween party here at the 88.1?
Is Mr. Bill Johnson is the winner.
Yeah. You know, I thought maybe for a split second that someone might say that as a joke, but you got to be kidding me.
No, it's not a joke.
Bill
Johnson,
best costume.
I'm not saying it to make you mad. He really won. People thought he was the best. He's costume winner for the Jolly Green Giant. That's what he is, right?
No. Okay, yeah, maybe you're right.
Well, that's
maybe,
what
maybe
everybody
that
thought he was, and that's what he won, Jolly Green Giant.
No,
so
he's not
the
Jolly Green Giant. He
Jolly
thinks
Green
he's something
Giant
else, but you're absolutely friggin' right.
That's the winner
the Jolly
of,
Green
of
Giant.
The costume contest.
Let's hear it for the Jolly Green Giant, who won the goddamn costume competition. Yeah, you happy, Bill? You won. So, you know, I mean, obviously we were wrong. Your costume is really good.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure.
Yeah, if you're supposed to be like a ball of green shit.
This is not a Jolly Green Giant costume. I am the Hulkamaniac.
You make me.
You know, the Hulk, the wrestler, Hulk Hogan.
Sour Patch Kids.
Yeah. What'd you think I was?
Yeah, no, get the hell out of here. You're starting to bug me.
The green is just, you know, some
real
fancy.
Okay, so that's it for this bullshit. Shut up. We had our musical guest
get out.
Drive off a cliff. Bill won the goddamn costume contest that makes absolutely no sense to me. Radar told a ghost story that truly terrified me to the bone and made no sense to me. And I just want to get the F out of here. Happy Halloween, everybody. I hope you choke on a Twix. I hope you choke on a chunky, or whatever. What are the kids eating nowadays as far as candies? They got the Airheads, and the sour faced fucks.
Party's going crazy.
Everybody.
Oh, boy, that's so
out there. Whoa, things are getting a little out of control. Is that the next part? You might have run out of a lot of food or something.
There's
a
lot
of sad gentles. I hope that works for the sharing ones. I don't have to phone. Get the coffee.
Yeah, there's definitely an adventure. That's for sure.
He's going to get the coffee.
Get out of here.
Oh, let him just let
we'll
him go.
See you, next week.
We'll see you next week.
November,
we're done. News is, I'm done.
And hopefully everybody will still be alive.
Great as always.
Yeah.
Take a shower.
Take a
shit.
Take a shower.
Happy Halloween.
Get shit.
Rocktoberfest, heavy metal bands. Rocktoberfest is here tonight and tomorrow night only at Bob's Metal and Punk Bunker. Bob's Metal and Punk Bunker. Rocktoberfest 2020 tonight and tomorrow night only. Cattle Decapitation, Graveyard Shift, Curvature of the Wind, Infected Dimples,
Buried in My Grandma's
Yard, Burned at the Stake, Bubonic Plague, Black Death, Morning Sickness, Spastic Bladder, In My Yard,
Brain Tumor,
In My Yard,
Brain Trooper,
In My Yard,
Brain Tumor,
Chapped Ass,
In My Yard.
Also for a limited time on the second stage, Fear of Clothing,
In My Yard,
Coke Bottle in the Ass, Fructose Intolerance, Oriental Nightmare Death Machine,
Metal Measles,
Rum Fit Syndrome,
In My Yard,
Lidocaine Poison,
Lack of Hustle,
Irregular
In My Yard,
Frothing at the Crotch, Wrapping It Up, and closing out Rocktoberfest 2020
here
only and tonight and tomorrow night only at
Metal
Bob's
Punk
and Metal Bunker.
Bob's Metal and Punk Bunk. Come soon and get tickets for next year's Tick-Borne Rickets.